Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up, we'll look at the recent updates to Microsoft Teams. As more and more of us are working remotely, Teams has become the go-to app for digital collaboration, online meetings, and the unified canvas to deliver powerful integrated app experiences. Now let's start with what's new in meetings. First, we've increased the number of simultaneous video streams from 4 to 9 of the most recently active. Now we've also added raise hand, and with that you can raise or lower your hand using the icon that you see here. Now it's great for impromptu polling or asking questions and getting the attention of other participants or the presenter. Now once you've raised your hand, you'll be able to see all the different hands are raised in the People tab, and you will be able to see if multiple people have their hands raised at once. Another thing that we've improved is the pre-join experience. So now when you join a meeting, you'll be able to choose from your device settings with the gear icon. You can also choose to enable or disable your camera. You can change your audio settings before you join through these buttons on the right, and even your background filters. So here I can, for example, decide to blur my background, or I can use any number of the built-in room configurations that we have as part of background effects in Teams. When I'm ready to join, everything that I've configured has been configured, and the meeting just works. And another new capability, especially great for teachers using ad hoc or channel meetings, is the ability to run meeting options as part of that meeting. So here I'm going to join another meeting, and you'll see that once I join, I can expand out the People tab, and now I can go in and see a new button here with a check X that basically will open meeting options. Now that's going to allow me to pick only me as the presenter. This is great. If you saw my tip for preventing participants from removing each other or muting each other during a meeting, this actually expands that control then to non-scheduled meetings as well. And to make it easier to manage more tasks in Teams during meetings, the meeting window itself can actually be popped out and you can resize it and also place it outside of your Teams app. Now this is great here for being able to have full real estate across multiple monitors. And future meetings, by the way, will remember this preference and pop out meetings by default, as I just showed in the demo. Now, beyond enhancements to the meeting experience, let me show you a few other new capabilities when using Teams. First, to make it easier to build new teams, we've added templates in Teams. Now, when you create a new team, you'll be able to just go through the normal process, but here you'll see templates that are both from my organization and built-in templates for hospital, retail, or an event. Here we'll see the channels are pre-configured as well as apps as part of this template. When I tap on start, I'll be able to make it private, public, or org-wide. I can give it a name, and I can even give it a description. Then when I tap create, it's going to go in the background and create that team. Once it's finished, I can start to manage that team with members or additional customizations I want to make to the team. Now to manage templates from the Teams admin experience in the admin center, all you have to do is go to Teams, Team Templates. Then you'll see all the different team templates that you have here enumerated. If you want to add another one, tap the Add button. You can create a new template, use an existing team, or modify an existing template. In my case, I'll do that, and I'll modify the Manage an Event template that I've already got. And here I'll just rename it. So I'll call it Contoso Event Management. And now I can click, or I can give it a description, and I can click Next. Now I have all the channels that we just saw, but I'm going to add another channel. So here I'll add a vendor management channel. And then I can additionally add an app. So in this case, I'll add Excel to this. And then I'll give that tab a name. So we'll call it vendors. And that's going to be able to display our vendors through an Excel app. Now when I apply the changes, I can go back to my list of all my team templates. And I can click in, make any changes I might want to make to the team template. And it's ready for me to use. Now we've also focused on search within Teams. Let me show you. So here, if I just hit the Control F key, it's going to scope search to just the team channel or chat that I'm in. So here you can see I've searched for guidelines, and I can see all the different results, and that will take me directly to those different chat items within that channel in this case. And another great way to work together is to use Microsoft Lists. It's a new capability in Microsoft 365, and it's an app that helps you track information and organize your work. Now, lists are simple, smart, and flexible, so you can stay on top of what matters most to your team. Now, with these, you can track issues, assets, routines, and contacts, inventory, and more using customizable views like you see here, and also smart rules and alerts if you want to keep everyone in sync. Now, this, for example, is a list of job applicants in HR. Now, if I want to, I can easily click into Aaron's line item here, and I'll see all the different status and the related chat from the team. Now here I'm just scratching the surface on what you can do with Microsoft Lists, but you can learn more at aka.ms/Microsoft Lists. Let me show you another pop-out experience. So here we have an app that's been pinned to my left navigation. And what I can do is pop out the app as well and get a nice resizable windowed view of my application. In this case, it's an in-house developed Power App. Now, if you're keeping score at home, that means we can pop out chats, meetings, and even apps as resizable windows within Teams. So those are updates to some of the core built-in Teams experiences, but let's switch gears to the ways that Teams can be customized with your own apps and services. Now, I'm gonna start with pro developers. So we've built Teams integration into Visual Studio. So here, when you set up a Microsoft Teams project, you can do everything you need to, including setting up the project to be either a tab, a bot, or a messaging extension as an app extensibility option for Teams. We can also validate and test our apps from within Visual Studio directly. And finally, the great thing is we can publish directly to our organizational app store, or we can publish to Teams in the public app store as well for other organizations to be able to use our apps. Now, if you're not a pro developer, what we like to call citizen developers, Power Apps is a great way to build rich and scalable apps to target mobile devices, your internet, and of course, Microsoft Teams. So here from within the Power Apps Designer, I can easily create my app. This is a service desk app that I've created. Now to publish that into Teams, we've made that easier than ever. So first, when we go to publish the app, we just have to click on Add to Teams. And then once we do that, we can actually go into our store. We'll add that app so that others will be able to view the app from within their experience. And now as a user, if I click on the ellipses or if I add a tab, I can search for my app and add that here. And here you can see the same service desk app that we just saw within Power Apps here in the context of Teams. And for IT, we've also extended the management controls for your custom apps. Now before, you could curate apps that were published to the Team App Gallery by Microsoft partner developers. And now you can do the same thing for your in-house developed apps. Let me show you what that looks like. So here I have all the different apps that I'm managing in my organization. If I just sort the custom apps here, you can see these are all the ones that I've uploaded or published directly into my Teams environment, either from Power Apps or from Visual Studio, and that's gonna show up right here in the management console. And as I showed you earlier, you can now use Teams templates to provision apps out for your users as part of team creation. So that was a quick overview of the new capabilities in Microsoft Teams as we approach the halfway point of 2020. For a comprehensive roundup for all the new capabilities in Microsoft Teams, check out aka.ms/teams2020updates, and thanks for watching.